So yesterday we were working on this Dell and we could not find the media short. So I'm going to look up schematics for this, see if there are any schematics available, and then we can figure out what coils are the ones that are flickering and inject power somewhere around there and go from there. So the model number of this motherboard is, here we go, LA-F551P. LA-F551P, okay. Let's bring in window capture here, LA-LA-. F5. Here we go. R5. 17 R5. Wonder, not wonder. Okay, we really want to see. PR10. PR10. What's this one? Coffee Lake. Okay, what are these? Similar? Yes, it is indeed. Okay, good. So what we're looking at is, turn the board around, we're looking at here, let's rotate this like that. Okay, what voltage will this be? Charge B, PL, B, okay, okay. So what we're going to do then is this. Let me set up the environment so we can all see what the hell is going on. Okay, let's cut this, move it around, move it around. Okay, let's bring, I'll disconnect the power, so power is disconnected, power on. Okay, 0.5, do your magic. Okay. Now ideally, we should do this on the main power, the blue one, because it probably will give more power, more reliable power, because some boards may need that sudden rush of amps to jump start. I'm just making that up, I could be wrong. Okay, so what we're interested in is this area here. So we did see some sort of a jumpy behavior of the voltages. Okay, nothing. Nothing. Okay. Right. So, before the interruption, so we've got some very popular chips going on here, 5X. Okay, which I believe 3 volt is generated from somewhere here. LP. So this should be a 3 volt line. Now, where is the 3 volt? Where is my 3 volt coil? DUR. Okay, which one of you guys? Okay, let me have a look at it this way. Let me go back to here. You, sir, your 5 volt always online. 3 and 5, no. Okay, this is it. 3 volt. It's near to the speaker. So this guy should be 3 volt always online. Okay. What's the resistance? So let's cut the power, or let's check the voltage first. Do we have 3 volts there? No, we don't. We got 0.02. Okay, so our problem could be somewhere here. Okay, could be a partial short on the PCH. We don't know. The best way to know, let's cut the power, check resistance. What's the resistance on 3 volt rail? Okay, doesn't look bad. So we're gonna do the reverse method of solving this problem. We're gonna go from, instead of looking for outputs of power, we're gonna go through inputs of power. We're gonna inject power. Okay, so we're gonna first get this power sorted. Voltage 1 volt, amp 0.5, that's good. Let's show the benchtop power supply and show me what you read when I give you. One volt. Okay. Just check that's the good ground. Okay. So 1 volt, nothing. Voltage 2 volts. 0.5, nothing. Voltage 2.5, 0.1 amp. Voltage 3 volts. Good, no short. Okay, how about our 5 volt rail? This guy here is the 5 volt always on, which is a giant one. Okay, here we go. Let's start again. 1 volt. Nothing. Voltage 3 volts. Okay. Voltage 4 volts. Okay. Voltage 5 volts. That's also fine. Okay. Yeah, this will be the high voltage. Charger B, PL 1701. Okay. How about this guy near the RAM? 1.2 volts. Volt 1.2 to the one next to the RAM. RAM is not on yet. Okay, nothing's happening. So all the coils there, they look fine. Okay then. So where is the issue? How about these guys here? What voltage are these working on? So we got these two big coils, these ones. 1.35 VGAP. Let's see, so these ones that supply power to the VGA. We have a bunch of MOSFETs there. Here, here, these guys. The NBVD 1.55 volts. Okay. Let's just do voltage 1 volt. Our ground is good. Nothing's happening. And then we'll go to here, these two guys, 1.35. Ah, okay, we have a short there. Bummer. So what's that powering? Okay. Hopefully the problem is O0Z something. Or maybe it's BAA. Okay. Let me check the resistance of those two. So let's go resistance mode and check these two. It's about 100 ohms here. They're about 100 ohms. I would say that's normal. Power VGA core. Phase 2. The capacitor there. VS. This MOSFET. Okay, let's just check one of these MOSFETs, see if any of them are playing up. So that's Gate to source. It again. Four point 5 kilo ohms. I wonder if this MOSFET is playing up. Here. Charging. It's also charging. This guy. This is intriguing. Why does this guy have such a low resistance? And how about this guy? PL800, 1 volt. The top one. PL800. So that's a 1 volt, 163 ohms, and this one is 1.35, and it is much lower resistance. So there is definitely a partial short there, I think. Yeah, I think so. So for example, if I do voltage 0.9, for example, and I inject that into the 1 volt line, which is above that, let me get my orientation correct. Okay, so this guy here, that's ground to here. What do we get? See, nothing being taken. Now I'm gonna put it into here. There we go. There is a partial short. So what does this mean? I suspect a MOSFET, but I could be wrong. But we'll find out. It could be, you know, that BAA or 0Z chip. Let's have a look. Let's see what we find out. And what's happening with the world? Okay, what am I doing? I need to inject power, that's what I'm doing now. Okay. Alright, so let's put a ground somewhere there. Definitely that's ground. We got 0.9 volts, so I'll do it like this. Okay. Okay, hopefully we can see something. Why don't I see anything getting hot? Okay. let me remove the remove that. Okay. What? Don't tell me it's gone. Okay, we'll let it take more amp. Amp, let's say 1 amp. Voltage 1 volt. Is it the PCH? One volt, 1 amp. What's getting hot? Don't tell me it's a GPU. I think it may be the GPU. Here we go. Okay, do it again. Since it's a 1.35 volt line, we can go one voltage to 1.2. Okay, so that's safe. Yeah. I'm gonna stick to GPU now. We're being partially shorted. So it will take more amps, so amp, we can go 2 amps. Yep, definitely. Definitely the CPU, GPU, unfortunately. It's partially shorted. That will be my hand on the left hand side. Yeah. Okay, so let's go back to this diagram quickly. So if you have a look at yeah, 1.35 VS. VGA core phase 2, it's after that side, comes into here, yeah, and then into the okay, that explains a lot. Okay, all right, so fortunately we're going to leave it here. This one is going to be a no repair. So when you can't find anything obvious, you have to do reverse method. Quicker, more dangerous. Not recommended. Even I make mistakes in this one, so it's in this power injection method, so it's very dangerous. You have to be really careful. Okay. So, partially shorted GPU. Alright, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.